Don't you know who I am? Why, of course you do. Why, this is Fuss Eldridge, the commander-in-chief of the Army of Fun. By jolly girls, but you look great. Honest you do. Now, you fellas say you take my advice, will you? I want to have a nice, quiet, heart-to-heart talk with the men. Girls, why not like you two talking to these fellas? Say, boys, now's your time to get married. You take my advice and get married, and when you marry, marry a widow. That's right. George Washington married a widow. George Dewey married a widow. I married a widow. None of you young, silly, sipping, gum-chewing slips of girls for me. No, sir. Give me the good, fat old widow every time. She's the stuff. You don't have to hang around in front of her house on a cold winter's night making love to her, freezing your feet off, scared to go in, fear the old man will hand you one and make you do a huckery buck out the back door. You don't have to ask her every night for a year to marry you. And every time you ask her, she says, I don't know whether I want to get married or not. Not the widow. All you got to do is go down into the neighborhood where there's three or four good, healthy widows living, that's all. Go down there and whisper to the four winds of heaven that you are desirous of entering into the holy bands of wedlock. And if one of them don't land you inside of 24 hours, well, it's because you take to the tall trees and pull the trees up after you. Now, just look how much better off you are when you marry a widow. Why, you marry a young girl in the first 4 years of your wedded life, you're worried to death. You're scared you ain't going to get your furniture paid for. You don't know one minute the installment man will back a wagon up against the house and take away all your goods and chattels. But marry the widow. And the minute the ceremony is over at the church, you take her upon your manly arm and you walk her right straight into her own beautifully furnished flat. Everything all ready and waiting for you. Ton of coal in the cellar, barrel of flour in the kitchen, and the first husband's clothes hanging up in the closet. What more do you want, huh? Take that home and think it over, will you?